Well, then I believe that Jonathan maybe needs to make an appointment to see Dr. Hudson.
Okay, all right. Jonathan, you want me to get your schedule?
I don't know why I have to talk to him. You're the financial aid person, and you're the one that's charging me for 18 days, and I didn't go 18 days.
But we've had some other issues, so we'll talk when Dr. Hudson's here.
There's been no other issues.
We need to talk to Dr. Hudson.
Okay, so you want to schedule a meeting with you all and Rick together? Okay, okay.
Okay, that sheet of paper that you're charging me, do I get that?
I'll happy to make you a copy.
Let's make a copy of it, because you're charging me 18 days, and I didn't go 18 days, so you're charging me for 18 days, and I didn't do it.
So, Jonathan, why don't we, can we set it up for tomorrow?
Sure, I have a 2 o'clock, I have a 9 o'clock and a 2 o'clock.
Okay, all right. So, Jonathan, could you do sometime tomorrow morning, maybe?
Yeah.
Okay.
I can set something up.
Okay, all right, let's set something up, and then Gina, you can do that.
I'll go make a copy. You go ahead and set something up. I'll make a copy of this for you.
And you're going to come back?
Yes.
I don't know. I just don't trust you guys. You guys have lied so many times to me. It's incredible how many times you all have lied to me.
And Gina's going right down the hall, making a copy.
Well, she said, yes, so, I mean, that's not a, it's a fair question.
Right, but yeah, and yes was a fair answer.
She said, it's real snotty.
And that was yes is a fair answer.
It was snotty.
Well, I want you to hear that is not the case.
All right. Well, I mean,
take your concern seriously and I'll investigate it. And I need to ask questions in order to do that.
Yeah, I wish you would have investigated you all fucking up my life. I wish you would have investigated that as much as you're investigating me on this. So, I mean, it seems my allegation needs to be investigated, but your all's allegations, that's not being investigated at all. It was all on hearsay. All on hearsay.
Well, I mean, again, I don't have any control over...
You do. You do. You do. And I think you have influence. And if you would have said, hey, hey, what actually went on? And I told you about all this stuff. I mean, it doesn't matter. Like, I told you about it. She bullied me for 3 days, and I was just supposed to accept it. And then when she told me to leave, I left. And then you all threw me out of the university, even though I had a student teacher candidate. It left, I could have done my work. I could have done everything. But you all just said, fuck you. We're going to fuck up your life. And sorry, I don't play. I don't like to play games with my life.
Well, I mean, again, during the meeting, we made sure, I mean, you had your say, and you were recording us without our permission.
At the very end, I started recording you, when you all started to sit there, at the very end, when you started commanding, getting in my face and telling me, you will give us money, or you will, whatever it is, she was ordering me like a dog, and I'm just supposed to sit there and take it. And no, I'm not going to just sit there and take it, so I was recording the disrespect that I was receiving, because apparently you didn't see it.
Well, we certainly may have different perspectives.
And it's official business. It's official business. What would be the problem with recording official business? It's $100,000. That's a lot of money. That is a lot of money.
Well, again, I understand your frustration. I don't want to dismiss that. I think that you definitely have had a difficult experience.
Okay. So what do you want to do about the... Where are we standing at now? I mean, I just overslept. That's all the reason I missed the meeting today. So if you want me to come in, I can be there in an hour. If you want me to be there at 4, if you want to this.
I need to leave, but I'll go ahead and I'll make it such that amount due is gone.
Okay.
And that your transcripts are released.
Okay. I mean, if you do that for me, then, I'll just all I have is whatever I say on Facebook or whatever, but anything else, I'm not going to,
It would be awesome if you took that, God Raped Mary video down.
Yeah, it would be nice if you all wouldn't have wasted 2.5 years of my life and then give me my $100,000 back.
Fair enough.
That's the solution to America's race problem is to figure out to destroy whiteness and destroy blackness and to start talking about precisely who we all are. No, we are not defined by our skin color. Our nationality helps, but really there's just so many more things to it than that. But me being an African does, it does change my perspective on who I am in this world. I have 11% African blood. Where did that come from? Let's learn about the Cincinnati riots of 1855. So the clashes between the nativists and German Americans. The nativists supported J.D. Taylor, the mayoral candidate. During the riots, German Americans erected barricades in the street leading into their Over the Rhine neighborhood. Right now, right, you had the Irish was in the West End, which is the ghetto, the so-called ghetto now. And Over the Rhine was a German neighborhood, which is considered the ghetto of Cincinnati. So the West End is, I don't know if there, I couldn't see, there are some ghetto spots in the West End. I can't, there's some really nice houses in the West End too, so I can't really call the West End, the whole place a ghetto. But there's, you know, there is a lot of crime and some bad things that happen there. And then Over the Rhine is the ghetto of Cincinnati. So both of them were formerly enclaves of white Europeans, you know, of other Europeans that were coming over and getting the racism. And in fact, how did all these people, all these white people, eventually become enveloped into the American system? I had read that basically the entire American, you know, system was how to screw over the black man. So these Germans and Irish, when they're faced with civil war and attacking the Germans and World War One and World War Two and all this other bullshit, they basically pushed them out and they basically made them into English-speaking WASP. They sort of shamed them and made sure that they did not carry on their heritage and culture. Those Germans who carried on their heritage and culture have very close families. Those who do not have, you know, lots of inner family strife and war. So the Cincinnati riots of 1855, there are clashes, right? I already mentioned that. See, they fired cannons, right? They're barricadings in the street, mobs of nativists. So basically, it's a fucking war, right? But that's war things. That's trench warfare was what they did in World War One. And this is 1855. What's going to happen in 6 years? This is going to, this national issue of nativism, foreigners, who's allowed to be an American, who's not allowed to be an American, slavery at all.
I mean, again, I don't feel good making that a condition, so I'm not going to do that, but, again, right. I'm going to go ahead and take care of this piece, and I will call you next week, or call me, if you don't hear from me by Wednesday, call me, and we will do the interview piece, so I can get some more information to proceed with my investigation.
So, okay, cool. That sounds fair, that sounds wonderful. The, when I'll have to reorder those transcripts through your all's the National Clearinghouse or whatever. So when will that be released? Will that be released today, or do I need to call you guys later to find out if this actually got done?
I would probably give it 24 hours.
Okay.
Can you do that?
I could do that.
Okay, because that's just usually like if we put it in this afternoon. Sometimes I think that it takes 24 hours for the systems to all update.
Okay.
Does that make sense?
Yeah, it makes sense. So that's cool. That's cool.
Again, I know that I hear what you're saying that you don't believe this, but I really want to reiterate. I can speak for myself and say that I know I've wanted to make sure that you were treated fairly.
Yeah, I know that you, like, judiciously, I feel like it, but sometimes, I don't know, I'm just going to speak honestly, I'm not trying to be like me, I feel like it's sort of false generosity, it's sort of, I care, I'm listening, but here's what you need to do because I'm the boss, and get in line, just submit, because that's what Elizabeth Rogers said, so you just need to bow down, like, you know, like, it just feels fake, I don't know, I mean, I wish I could feel like I could trust you guys, but I can't, you guys have been shitty to me for 2.5 years, and I can just tell you that and you can believe me, or you know, I don't feel comfortable with you, and I don't know how to make it better, but maybe there if y'all would have just let me do my student teaching. I don't know why that was such a crime for me to go ahead and try to do my own student teaching, but the I don't know, you know, how can I be happy with this? I mean, come on, give me a break, seriously, like, I don't have to go back into all that, but again, like, I'm not happy with the 2.5 years I was actually there, and I feel like I could have, like, ignored all the crimes if y'all would just let me get my job and go on with life, but, you know, you didn't let me do that, so I can't ignore the crimes that y'all committed against me.
Well, we'll talk next week, and we'll do that interview piece.
Okay.
And I'm going to send, also I don't want to surprise you, I'm going to send you that letter about the persona non grata. If you need to deal with somebody, just deal with me, and I'll be your go-between.
Yeah, that letter too, that doesn't sit well with me. But that's fine. Y'all do what y'all need to do, and I'll do what I need to do, and then hopefully, you know, we can peacefully just let me transfer, let me go on, and that's it. that's fine all with right. me. So, all right, cool. I appreciate.
If there's a problem with the clearinghouse, you know, call me. But I'll you know, endeavor to make sure that peace goes through.
I would greatly appreciate that. I mean, shit, just y'all didn't have to, you know, just let me get my transfer on. Let me, you know, go on. I appreciate it, man.
All right.
All right.
Take care.
Bye. Yeah, this fucking disgusting fucking pervert in charge of sexual harassment. This motherfucker, I told him about the sexual harassment that I had received, and he didn't give a shit. Neither did Elizabeth Rogers. Sexual harass a man, it doesn't give a fuck. I mean, I couldn't tell if they was oppressing me just because I was a student or a man. Is all students have to be fucking slaves and shit, and being a slave is somehow supposed to make me a strong, independent leader? Give me a fucking break. That's some bullshit. Or because you're a man, so therefore, I mean, I'm the minority. I'm the minority in the education field. And instead of actually looking at that perspective, it's like, well, the politicians are men, and my husband's a man, and I don't know. I couldn't tell. I think it's a combination of both. I think they're white women, so they think they can get away with anything, up to murder, and also think they're oppressor, molester professors, and I think that they have no fucking moral core, give a shit about anybody, or that's how they get off, is to fucking yell at their fucking students and to treat them like shit. They get off to that type of shit. So no, they don't advocate for students' rights. They don't fucking do any conflict resolution. They only want to fuck you over. That's it. Richard Hudson only wants to fuck you over. He can only fuck the students over. He can't do shit to the fucking professors. He can't even do shit to the fucking operators that lie to you. And there's nothing that this motherfucker, you know, he probably could do a whole bunch, but he's unwilling to do any fucking thing. Unless, I don't know, I mean, he had a lot of attractive women in his office, so I guess he likes to surround himself with a lot of young women to make them do his bidding, which is, you know, that's wonderful. Right? This sick fucking monster. No wonder he can't fucking see what sexual harassment. He's a fucking... The Spalding University is an incubator for pedophiles. Professor molester oppressors. They don't care about you. They just care about... they just give a shit about their power. They want you to be a fucking slave. So 100% compliance. That's what Spalding University... That's all they give a fuck about. Erupts 6 years later, and then it carries on. There's a second wave of immigrants that come during the 1870s and 1880s when Reconstruction fails. So the racism pervades for about, you had a glorious period for black people between 1865 and 1877. For 12 years, black people actually were free to be free. You know, they're allowed to do as they pleased. And in fact, South Carolina, the majority of the legislature were African American. They were black. And so the black people had taken over one of the southern states. But once the southerners saw that they were getting power, the Freedmen's Bureau came down. So the northerners established this bureau to make sure that the black folks would be treated correctly. In fact, some of the lands that they had taken, they give to black folks. So the Freedmen's Bureau was incredible. It was a good example for democracy. The period between 1865 and 1877 is a really important time period that we all should read and learn about, because it was a time of glorious achievements. You know, the black people have been 1950s and 60s. It took, you know, the civil rights movement for them to finally get freedom and for them finally to be treated as American citizens. When, you know, this had been white supremacist oppression has been going on a long time. I was actually trying to make a different point. But the in 1855, Know Nothing riots, they nominated a slate of candidates, and so that's just what happened. So this is in Cincinnati, right? So the Cincinnati had the 1855 Know Nothing riots, just like the Louisville had Know Nothing riots. And this is the fucking biggest fucking issue in the world for Spalding University and JCPS Social Studies. They don't want their students to know about the 1855 Know Nothing riots. They don't want them to talk about their roots. They don't want white people to know what, you know, just keep maintaining the white supremacist totality. Waspy system. So he keeps on sending me fucking emails over and over again. He doesn't fucking stop because he's a fucking oppressive fucking piece of shit. Just like a fucking molester that he is, right? No, I don't want your fucking emails. Well, I'm a molester and I don't care about your person or your dignity or anything about you. And I'm just going to keep on molesting your fucking email. That's Richard G. Hudson, a fucking bitch of all time. They did more than just... They completely lied, okay? So they completely lied. It wasn't even so much about, we demand 100% compliance here. They said, actually, we're going to expect co-teaching tactics here, sixth co-teaching tactics. And that's how, you know, that's not about hierarchy anymore, being somebody else's slave. It's about working together and being that dynamic duo. Julie Chancellor, there's no dynamic duo with her. She was an absolute fascist, Nazi piece of shit. She was rude. She was mean. She was nasty.